In this video, we're going to take a look at the completely revamped Amazon Inspector. Now, this vulnerability management service first launched in 2015, and it was great. But over the years, it started to show its age, and it was breaking down under some new fundamental ways that we are using the AWS cloud. Well, here at AWS reInvent 2021, the team has completely revamped and relaunched a brand new modernized Amazon Inspector. Now, there are three main reasons why this one is way better than the original version. The first is that it's easier to deploy. Gone is the specific Amazon Inspector agent. Now it leverages the AWS Systems Manager agent, which is commonly deployed on almost every AWS managed AMI. They've also integrated with AWS organizations to make it easier to one-click deploy and enable Inspector across all of your accounts. That is amazing, fantastic user experience there. The second point is that it is now a continuous service. Previously, you had to point Inspector at something and say, hey, make an assessment here. That assessment could be 15 minutes, 30 minutes, up to 24 hours, and then you would get results, findings back from that assessment. Now it just works. It just automatically discovers resources and starts scanning them continuously for you. Huge, huge win there. And the third key new feature is that Amazon Inspector has expanded into scanning container instances stored in your Amazon ECR or Elastic container registry. Now, you may be saying, well, wait a minute, doesn't the registry already do that? Yes, it does. It leverages Inspector to do that. There is a basic push to scan that uses the open source tool Claire to scan for basic CVEs. And there's an enhanced paid version of push that leverages Inspector with its enriched threat intelligence, or you could do it directly through Inspector here. Now, I have set up a couple basic things. I played around with the service for a few minutes. It is really, really easy to use as long as you know the one gotcha. We're going to walk in through that right now. The new version of Amazon Inspector really focused on an improved user experience, and they delivered. Here I have the last stage of launching a new Amazon EC2 instance. I'm going to do that right now. That is a Amazon Linux instance. Now, the only thing that you need to know, and you absolutely need to know this, is that any instance that you want scanned by Inspector needs to have permissions to work with Amazon Systems Manager. So there is a managed policy from AWS. It's the Amazon SSM Managed Instance Core Permissions Policy. If you attach that to the role that you're using, then Inspector will automatically pick it up. If you don't, Inspector is going to find the instance and say that it's not scannable. It's going to show it to you in your inventory, but it'd say, hey, I can't scan this because it doesn't have permissions to access Systems Manager. So we've done that. It's launching. Let's just refresh here. It still hasn't found that instance, but it's only been a couple seconds. Let's refresh, and there it is. So even though Amazon Inspector has already found this instance, the instance isn't ready. It hasn't finished its status check. So once it does and it registers itself with AWS Systems Manager, then Inspector will be able to actually connect and scan this instance. But the good news is we didn't actually do anything. Inspector just automatically found this instance. And while we're waiting for that instance to be scanned, you can see that we also have one ECR registry. Now that registry only has one image. I uploaded about a 6 month old image of Apache HTTPD, the web server, in there, and automatically without me doing anything other than just loading that image into my registry, Inspector is finding a bunch of these vulnerabilities. We found 15 critical vulnerabilities out of 229 findings in this one container image. It's not a good image to use in production, which is why there's a whole bunch of updates to that image, but I uploaded the old one on purpose so that we would find this. Now, I just refreshed, and you'll notice that here we are about 2 minutes, a little under 2 minutes after launching my EC2 instance. I have 100% coverage. Inspector is also scanning that EC2 instance for any particular findings or vulnerabilities. So you can see how easy it is to set up Inspector. There's really not that much setup. You just need to remember to assign the proper role for Systems Manager to your instances. Other than that, everything's pretty much automatic. And so then Inspector goes to work. It starts scanning, looking for vulnerabilities in your instances, in your container images. And when it discovers something, it bubbles up what's called a finding. Let's dive in and take a look at a specific finding. So I've clicked on container images on the left. I'm going to dive into this particular container image. You can see we have way too many vulnerabilities. We have 15 critical vulnerabilities alone. Let's scroll down and look at the details of one of those. In this case, we're going to look at this libxml2 finding. And you can see on the right-hand side, right off the bat at the top, we have what's called a CVE number, a common vulnerabilities and exposure identifier. Now it's 2017-73-76. This is a unique identifier for this particular vulnerability. If you're doing any research, if you're looking it up in the National Vulnerabilities Database, if you're Googling for any independent research or from the security community, this is going to be a reference for this particular issue. It's a great way to sort of anchor all the information about this particular issue around this CVE number. You can see we have just a generic title, which is libxml2, which essentially says in this XML processing library, which is very common on Linux distributions, there's an issue. But the description gives us a little bit more detail here. So there's a buffer overflow here, which means that a signed set of memory, this issue allows that memory to get filled up, and then bad things can potentially happen. In this case, what it allows is a remote attacker to execute arbitrary code. Those are the absolute worst words you want to hear. A remote attacker can execute their own code on your system by leveraging an incorrect limit for port values when handling requests. So basically, they can overload the system and run their own code on your systems. That's a bad thing. We always want to address these when it comes to security. And if you scroll down, you can see that this is reinforced by the additional information. It's a critical severity. When you look at the vulnerability details, it is an inspector score of 9.8, a CVSS, so this is the main scoring system that we use for these vulnerabilities now, of 9.8. That's bad. It's out of 10. Right? And then there's a whole bunch of letters and assigners after that. And that basically tells you how this vulnerability can be exploited, what the potential impact is. But we had all we need to know at the top. A remote attacker can execute their own code on your system. So basically, if they can take advantage of this vulnerability, they can own your system. This is very, very bad. The next thing we want to check is the related vulnerabilities. There's nothing related, so this is a solo isolated thing. It tells us the resource. In this case, it's our container image. And so we can click through and see that image. We can we have the ARN for that image, so we know where it's in use. There's no resource tags. And the remediation here is update. So patch this. There's a patch available. You need to update this particular thing to resolve that, which is a really good. That's a clear mitigation. So in this case, we as a builder team would look at this and say, whew, unless we have something that's specifically scanning for this vulnerability on the edge. So if we could use that using AWS WAF or another security control, if we don't have that type of mitigation before somebody reaches this container, then what we want to do is we want to make sure that we patch this. And because we're looking at a container image, we absolutely want to patch this and then update our image. That's how we handle a vulnerability, and that's the core value of Amazon Inspector. Now, the big benefits, again, of the relaunch of Inspector is that it is super easy to deploy now. It leverages AWS Systems Manager to make life easier as opposed to a custom agent. It does resource auto discovery as well. It integrates with AWS Organization, so super easy to get it out there, and it's now continuous. So instead of making those manual requests, it just constantly bubbles these findings up, and it will send those findings to EventBridge or to AWS Security Hub. So a lot of flexibility there is to route these. If you had tags, and you should be tagging resources, you could actually use those tags in EventBridge to properly route this request and say, hey, team who's responsible for this image, there's an issue that you need to do something about. That's a really powerful feedback loop for security issues. With the context, it's all included in that finding to make that important decision for the team to prioritize it. Is it more important to handle this bug or to update this particular container image? In this case, because it's so severe, it's important to update the image. And then finally, there is a couple gotchas here. So while we've got the expansion into containers, that's fantastic. We actually lost the support for Windows. So this is purely a Linux-only experience. For the vast majority of us, it's not a big deal. But Inspector, in its original form, actually supported Windows. So you can still use Inspector Classic, but until they migrate, and you may want to until they migrate Windows support into the new version of Inspector, but that is one gotcha, and no Windows support. And the second is you have to have the proper permissions on your instances to access AWS Systems Manager. It is a managed role, so it's Amazon SSM managed core instance, or instance core, one of the two. It'll be right here on the screen. And if you have that in place, you're good to go. So Amazon Inspector, extremely powerful, brand new relaunch. In addition to those two gotchas, what you need to know is pricing is based on the number of EC2 instances scanned, as well as the number of container images initially scanned on push, as well as the rescans for those container images within the month. So this service is not inexpensive at scale, but the value it provides is pretty significant. Now, the good news here is that this complements a lot of the APN partner offerings as well as stuff that you built yourself in the security practice. That's where that EventBridge integration and the Security Hub integration really comes into place, because what we're missing in some of these findings is the context. We don't know where this container image has been deployed. We don't know who's interacting with that container image. Same thing goes with the EC2 instances. So while Inspector inspector is zeroed in on telling you what's actually going on in the instance or in that container image. It doesn't tell you how it's being used. And that's important information for the context of these vulnerabilities and the potential impact that it may have on your environment. But this is a fantastic upgrade all around. The ease of use really makes it simple to get deployed out there. There's a 15-day trial. So even if you're concerned about the pricing, and you should very much do that pricing calculation before deploying it widely, you can give it a shot and see how much value it adds. It is one of those services where you need to remember what you're trying to do is protect the data and the value of that data to your organization. So calculate that ROI, but I love this integration. I love the smoothness of this. I love the ease of deployment. And I love how the findings bubble up those results to give you that information. If you partner this with a strong tool from an APM partner or some homegrown stuff, you're really going to have a complete tight feedback loop to help improve the security of your environment and of your builds. It's very much in line with the philosophies that we teach in the AWS Well-Architected Framework. Check out Amazon Inspector. It's newly relaunched. It's GA in most regions and available right now.